the second half of the season is underway, and sorry that I didn't get a chance to put a video out after the first episode of the second half of the season. So we are 2 episodes in, and I'm kind of glad that I waited, because episode was okay, but I really like what happened in the second episode a lot more. So we'll get into all that, you know, my thoughts and things. But first and foremost, I'd love to hear from any of you that watch, whether you've just started to watch it or you've been watching it since season 1 like I have. If you collect the comic books or the trade paperbacks, and I'd love to hear what you think about, you know, the season so far, and everything like that. So I'm also going to before we get into everything, I'm also going to do a beer review, and I also have some nom noms that I'm going to eat to have some pretzels. Cups miniatures, and the reason for these is because of the beer. My lovely wife was at the Wegmans supermarket, and she called me up and she said, "Hey, I'm here. Do you need any beer?" Trained her well. And I said, "Hell yeah." So she said, "What kind?" And I said, "Just pick up anything." And she says, "Well, what have you had?" And I really couldn't remember, you know, everything. So I just said, just do your best to try to pick out something that you may not have seen me pick up or whatever. So she picked up DuClaw. I think it's DuClaw. Yeah, DuClaw Brewing Company's Sweet Baby Jesus Chocolate Peanut Butter Porter. Chocolate Peanut Butter Porter. Wow, this, I'm not sure what this is gonna taste like, but I'm just picturing peanut butter cup in porter beer form. So it's 6.5% alcohol by volume. The bottle cap says "Craft be cherished, rules be damned." So it's a craft beer, of course. Drink responsibly on the side. Say that probably, and that's something that I always don't say in my videos, but I also, you know, make sure you drink to enjoy the beer, the wine, but know your limit and don't push it. Once you start to, you know, feel inebriated or you get a little buzz, that's it. You know, you don't need to keep pushing it. It says here on the side, a classic full-bodied robust with a smooth, dry finish and just enough hops to balance aromas and flavors of roasted malt, chocolate, and peanut butter, so rich that just one sip and you'll exclaim the name, Sweet Baby Jesus. So scent of that already. Peanut butter and, I guess, malt. Oh, I can smell peanut butter in that, for sure. Roasted malt. Ah, I love a porter. My favorite. Porters and stouts. I think I like porters more. Much of a head. So unfortunately, not too much of those beer foam sounds. But this is as black as you can get. This is pretty it's got that a slight bitter, but not an unpleasant bitterness. It's almost like a cocoa powder bitterness, if that makes sense, like a dark chocolate. Doesn't quite have the typical bottle cap sound, but episode of the second half. I guess you would say episode 9, right? It's 8. And 8, I think. 8 of the first season. Then they take a break. And then it's 8 more. So the first episode of the start of the second half of the season. It's just Carl. Cup. Sure, there you go. That's damn good beer. So, so I don't want to dissect both episodes in this one video. It would take too long. We also see Michonne. She's alive. She goes back to the prison from the woods briefly just to get two more companions. She severs their jaws. Them to some rope or something so she can walk among the walkers with these two companions, and they won't recognize her as being human. And eventually we see her in a pretty much of a I forget what they call it, a horde of zombies, about a dozen zombies that she's walking through the woods with. friend and her brother. I don't really know specifically, I forget. And eventually, and she's walking through the woods and she's trying to just go wherever she's going. She just realizes what she's doing, and she's just like, she doesn't want to have any part of it. There's one part where she comes out of the woods to a road, and I think she might have noticed some footprints on the road. She goes back across the road to the woods, and as she's in those woods walking, we know with all the other walkers, you know, that's when I think, to me, my take on it, I don't know what your take is, but to me, it's like, she had, like, what is she doing? Like, and she just starts killing all the walkers that are around her. And I think her humanity came out, and maybe she didn't want to be alone. I'm not sure, like I said, I'm not sure what you thought of that scene, but that was, to me, kind of what I felt. So she goes back to the road, and she starts following the tracks, and she ends up at the house where Carl and Rick are. At least, I'm pretty sure she does. You don't really know. You don't find out in this episode, and you don't find out in the, I guess, the 10th episode either. Meanwhile, Carl, the cocky little bastard, he ends up going house to house looking for supplies. He almost gets caught by some walkers. He escapes by the skin of his teeth. And he ends up coming back to the house, and he confesses to his father that he can't do it. That he can't survive on his own, because he said to Rick, "I can do this. I don't need you. I hope you die." I think he even said that at one point. And that's just youth, brashness, or that's just him being brash and trying to show, you know, his father or himself that he can do this. But he breaks down, and that was cool. I'm glad that he finally came around, and he's back to somewhat being the boy or the young teen that he is. He's probably 12 or 13 now, I would say. So the episode ended almost as if Michonne and Carl were both trying to prove that they could do this, but they both broke down, and they both realized that they need other people, I guess is pretty much, they both were human, you know, they broke down, so to speak. And so Michonne that Rick and Carl are in, she kind of finds a trail that leads them, that leads her there, more or less. And that was pretty much the first episode. It was just those three characters. Now, second episode of The Walking Dead much better than the previous one. I mean, a lot better. Episode, what becomes of Daryl and that girl? I think they end up at the train tracks where Tyrese also see Maggie's alive. Maggie's with, I think, that doctor. They got a bit of a drinking problem. And the other girl that showed up with Tyrese at the prison. They find the bus. It's full of walkers, but they don't find Glenn. You don't know this at first. You see Maggie kills a walker in the bus that has black hair and has the build of Glenn. But in the scene that follows, that poor Glenn was left alive by himself at the prison, left behind. Basically, he was up in a walkway that got hit by one of the shells of the tank, and he was kind of laying there walkway above ground, and he wakes up and there's a bunch of walkers below him, and he eventually gathers a bunch of equipment, gets some riot armor or riot suit, and he finds the younger girl that was with the governor when they showed up, and he helps her out because, you know, he's a good guy, but he also needs her as well to survive. You know, the more the merrier. Teaser. next video, if you respond to this video and leave comments about your thoughts and, you know, have any questions or just general comments about The Walking Dead, I will definitely mention your name and I'll read your comment in the next video. It's just a little something I'd like to do. So we can interact a little bit. I don't want to copy off of the Talking Dead that airs after the show. I don't even watch that. So far so good. Things are getting interesting again. It's good to see that all the main characters are alive, and it should be interesting to see what becomes of them the rest of the second half of the season. So thanks again for joining me. Hope you find this relaxing, whether you watch the show or not, and I hope it didn't spoil too much for you.